I'm Karen Brooks. I'm a songwriter, professional songwriter from Nashville. I've been writing songs for 25 years or so. I've had recordings by songs by Emmylou Harris, Patti Loveless, Ann Murray, Crystal Gayle, Tanya Tucker, and Roseanne Cash, and others. And I'm also a cowgirl, so I've had the opportunity to get out into America and in these small towns everywhere, met some of the finest people in the world. I think that the stars of these songs should be the people who listen to the radio, and so I've invited some of the finest songwriters in the world to come out with me into this U.S. of A. and collect stories to write songs about them. We've decided to come to Carrabelle on our first episode of a series called They're Playing Our Song. Well, let's call it Oysters and Pearls, seeing as it's a great food and pearls are known as songs, so we're gonna find some hidden treasures here and write some songs about them. I was thinking that we should get some songwriters out of the house a little bit. You know, they're all up there in these little Nashville writers' rooms writing, pulling people's heartstrings, writing about daddy's boy. I swear to God they're making it up. I think there's probably some firsthand experiences. Let me tell you where it started. I was building fence down in Texas with an old cowboy named Ray. We were building fence for about two weeks before he came up and came up with that old big chaw in his jaw, and he goes, "Are they all gone crazy up there in Nashville? Or are they all 21 and falling in love?" And he put up his hands, and they were all like, looked like they were road maps. And he goes, "Look at my hands. When are they gonna play my song?" So I thought maybe we should probably tell a story. And among others out there, it struck me that nobody was telling the truth, the story about some of the people that listen to radio.
Our song, just like you're talking about the old cowboy, where's his song? And you know, this community, they need a song.
I think they do too. I think there's a lot of stories out there that are not told. That the unsung heroes are the songwriters that are in the back of the whole backbone of the music business. And I think it would be nice to see them at work.
Explore
everybody.
That creative process. That
collect the information, get in there, and actually have people watch them write the song. Because I know also there's a lot of creative people out there that I think we're going to have some songwriters coming out of the woodworks.
Sure. Well, it would be great to have the performers, the writers, actually perform it. Because nobody ever hears their songs. They hear it from somebody else. Well, how do you get them down?
I think that they would always be out for a golf adventure.
Take them out on a deep sea trip, catch some wahoo or tuna.
I think that'd be fun. Is shrimping a very hard? I mean, I know it's productive.
Everybody take them out has on shrimp on their boat. Plate. We could take them out on a shrimp boat a night trip.
We could write our song, and the writers could write their song, and we can have dueling songs. We can see whose song's best. I like that.
There
idea.
You go.
I
yeah,
like a, that idea.
And let's contact the writers. And tell them what we've got going, and get them down here.
We can find out.
The thing is just to
a lot of things
to bring them to the area. Let them get familiar with the area.
Right.
Familiar with the culture, the people.
If they just want to go to restaurants and eat, they can go to restaurants and eat. If they want to fish, they can fish.
All right. That sounds like fun. It sounds like so much.
If they want to go on a shrimp boat, we'll line a shrimp boat up.
Let's invite them down. Let's see this. What do you think?
I think it's a great idea.
What better place than Carrabelle, Florida?
Yes.
The Big Bend.
We can feed them at least here at Fathoms, right?
It's the Redneck Riviera.
Yeah.
They'll be glad to come.
All right. We might get a song or two out of them.
You might not get rid of them.
Oh, that?